Emily. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
You look so pretty today. Those are lovely flowers. Where did they come from?
My garden.
Oh, so Emily, I have a question for you concerning mobile homes. Some people have asked me, what is the difference between a mobile home and a mobile home? Meaning one that is supposedly attached and one that is not attached to the ground. How would you treat it and how different are they?
Okay, so most of the time they'll refer to it as a manufactured home, and 90% of the time the mobile home would be in a park where they would lease the land or rent the land. And
that's when they are not attached to the
ground.
They're
not attached. They're in the park.
And if
that's, they will not be buying the land.
Oh, okay. So if that's the case, then how do you handle that?
If it's a mobile home park, all the transfer will go through the Department of Housing and Community Development. That's a state, which formerly was handled by the Department of Motor Vehicles.
Oh.
But the Housing and Community Development they regulate the mobile home parks and also modular homes. So they moved it over to that department of the state.
So what happens if it is already attached to a foundation?
Okay, if it's, usually they'll be getting the land and the home will be treated as real property.
Real property?
Real property.
Oh.
When they did the installation of that mobile home to the land, there's documents that are required and permits, and then that gets filed with the Department of Housing and Community Development. They will deactivate their file. And that form is called a 433A, which means installation to a permanent foundation. They then retreat it all. Most mobile homes in the park and mobile homes that are situated on land are under county taxes, just about all of them. Once in a while we'll get one that is still on registration.
Oh, okay.
Now there's another such scenario where they buy the land and the mobile home is not attached.
I see.
So that would take two processes in the escrow. One is to transfer the land, which is real property with title insurance, and then the other one would still go through the Department of Housing and Community Development to transfer the unit itself.
Great. So if we have any questions on mobile homes, or if you have any, we have any agents who are going to do mobile homes, they can give you a call, right?
Absolutely. And one thing I will mention is when they're purchasing a home in the mobile home park, the buyer needs to qualify with the park to be a tenant there.
Okay.
So that's kind of a primary thing that a real estate agent would want to get done, is to have the buyer apply to the park.
Okay, great.
Because if they don't get approved, then they cannot continue with the transaction.
Okay, great. Well, thanks, Emily. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
So this is Emily's room, and as you can tell, she has beautiful flowers in her garden. And if you have any mobile home questions, you can bring them to her. She is our mobile home expert, of course, plus everything else, like bulk sales and everything.
And frogs.
And what?
Frogs.
And frogs! She's a great collector of frogs. Thanks, Emily.
All
appreciate
right.
it.
Have a great day. Thank you.